and welcome to another episode of Design on Demand. I'm Matthew McMaster, and you're watching part three of our four-part series on black chrome plating. Today, Jamie and Ryan will be discussing some various applications that black chrome can be used for, as well as going over some various products that black chrome can be applied to. If you missed part one or two of this series, I'd encourage you to watch those now. Cool magic trick. Anyway, let's join Jamie and Ryan for part three.
So now we've talked about some advantages and what low temperature black chrome is all about. What are some of the applications or the uses that would be good for the product?
You know, there are several kind of core applications that are great for the product for kind of the same reason. Food, medical, and electronic assembly or semiconductor are kind of all three core verticals where you see this product used with some frequency. And it's largely because of that the ability to adhere to the underlying surface even after repeated deflection. So if you're making a sensitive product, if you don't want to have chrome flakes in your cornflakes, for example,
right?
You may want to consider low temperature black chrome as your preferred anti-corrosive solution,
right?
For like a food grade application that's going to see caustic washdown. If you're building a sensitive electronic product, obviously you don't want to introduce contaminant into that type of environment, or medical where you're going to have obviously some type of cleaning process to maintain sanitation. So
and we like for medical is a good example. I mean, we like the aesthetics of the items too, right? I mean, we don't want to be in our hospital bed or anywhere in getting a test done and see the
bunch of rust right next to you, right?
Well, you don't want to see a bunch of the rust, but you also want to see that, you actually don't want to notice, right?
Exactly.
The best things that you see are the ones that you don't see.
Absolutely.
In a lot of applications. And then, of course, with the medical, depending, you're doing tests with syringes and you're testing different things in
sure.
Petri dishes and so forth, you need something that's not going to corrode.
Sure.
So,
and then certainly the color is one of the attractive properties about it. It can maintain its resistance to corrosion, and you've
right.
got a nice dark color that doesn't reflect light.
Right.
That can be useful if you're looking at camera positioning, if you're doing light testing of some sort where you don't want to distort
right.
your potential readings with a more reflective type surface. This
right.
is a great option that's gonna reflect light, but also provide a robust.
It's clear that like a 52-100 polished steel is going to be almost as reflective as a mirror.
Yeah, it's pretty bright stuff.
If you start bouncing a laser around or something like that, in your application, it certainly would reflect highly, whereas something like this probably would not. So now that we know a little bit about applications, we know a little bit about the low temperature black chrome. What kind of products can we get this on from MISUMI?
Yeah, you can actually get this on a range of different components that we manufacture. Obviously, we mentioned linear shafts, but we also I think it's important to note we also plate post machining. So if you want to wrench flat on your shaft for one reason or another to kind of tighten it down or an OD thread, we're going to plate that entire surface. It's not a pre-machine plate. So a lot of people will go to, their local machine shop that's got a potentially a linear shaft chrome plated bar sitting on a shelf somewhere that they'll machine up for them. But they're not going to plate the machine surfaces after the plating is complete. And that's one of the real areas where we excel in terms of quality is how we both machine and then plate. So
that's great. That's a great advantage.
Absolutely.
And so what about the linear bushings?
Well, it really wouldn't make sense to have a linear shaft that was protected from corrosion without also similarly protecting your linear bearing.
Mm-hmm.
So you can actually get that on our linear bearings as well, both housed and unhoused.
Mm-hmm.
I think we have a range of different flanges that you could potentially apply the
sure.
the coating to.
Mm-hmm.
So
And how do we do that? Do we just do we coat just the outside of the bearing, or do we coat the whole interior surface and everything?
The whole thing. Wow. The whole thing. Well, that's, interior, exterior.
That's super.
Yeah.
I mean, that's you can't beat that. So we get a shaft that's got the low temperature black chrome all over it there inside, and after all the machining process is done and everything, and then you can put the bearing on there as well.
Yep.
Sounds like you'd be in very good shape from a round solution
perspective.
Well, good. So from a linear guide perspective, or a miniature linear guide perspective, we do something very similar that they do over on the round side. The difference is on a linear guide, we can do that up to, on any of the linear guides that we offer, up to 1,000 millimeters in length. And as you can see, or maybe not so well from out there, but the carriage or block is completely coated with the low temperature black chrome inside and out. And so that's going to make including the holes, the mounting holes. So you're not going to have any sort of corrosion issue at all going with the low temperature black chrome.
That's really great. I've seen applications where you'll have liquid that actually accumulates in those holes.
Right.
And they're typically the first portion of the rail to start corroding, and that's key.
Well, of course, MISUMI would be happy for you to buy some hole plugs. You know, we do offer hole plugs if you don't want things hanging out in your holes, but otherwise, if you don't buy the hole plugs, it's still plated, so yeah. You're good. You're covered either way.
Well, I mean, those hole plugs, they're great. And they're great for anti-corrosion, but all you need is some maintenance guy to come in and pop them all out, and he doesn't right. save them. And, you know, it's great while they're in there, but they certainly have the ability to be removed and discarded over time.
That's true.
For one senseless reason or another.
Plus, you know, it's worth mentioning, too, that the carriages have seals, you know, on the bottom and the sides. So, you know, that's going to help keep the debris and things like that out of there. But, you know, again, if you want the protection, it's available. It's a choice. We also offer ball and lead screws with the same black chrome plating option, and including the support blocks. So I'm sure most folks know, but the support blocks would be the things that mount at the end of your ball screw assemblies. And if you want to have the ball screw plated, with the nut and everything on there, you can mount that down, plate the support blocks, and you're completely plated up everywhere.
Absolutely.
So you could use the ball screw to coincide with the round shaft solution or the linear guide. And all of that's available with the black chrome. So in addition, MISUMI has a very wide and stout range of locating and pivot pins. With lots of different machine options and all that, and one of the options that we're proud to offer with those are the low temperature black chrome. And as you can see on the bottom left hand side of the screen there, one of the kind of hidden secret products that a lot of customers aren't aware of that MISUMI offers is a high precision stage. I have a lot of different configurations of this type of stage. Either an X, an XY, even an XYZ type stage. And in almost every case of these stages, low temperature black chrome is a plating choice. And that's because a lot of people like to use very high precision stages in a camera environment. You can set the camera on, you can make very small, minute adjustments. And of course, you don't want the light reflecting if you have a shiny, you know, camera light on you or on your thing that you're trying to photograph. You don't want the light bouncing around and messing up your picture. So you,
absolutely.
You go with that low temperature black chrome to keep the reflection down. Of course, we also offer plating options on knobs, screws, handles, and even washers. So lots of choices there. And of course, there's even more.
Yeah, and certainly if you're looking for something on our website and you don't see it and you think, hey, this would be a great plating solution for whatever product you're thinking of working with, certainly shoot us an email. We're going to have email addresses and contact information at the end of this presentation. but we're happy to take a look at any really industrial component you have that you'd like to use this plating system with. So
that's great.
Thank you for joining us here at Design on Demand. Join us tomorrow for part 4, the final part of our 4-part series on black chrome. Jamie and Ryan will be discussing how to order our products, stages and linear guides, as well as answering some very common questions about black chrome. If you missed part 1 or 2 of this series, you can catch up by clicking on the links to my left. As always, check out our social media and definitely check out our brand new blog, the MISUMI Mech Lab. If you like this video or any of our other videos, subscribe to our channel as we'll be uploading tons of great new content in the weeks and months to come. Thanks again for joining us, and we hope to see you back.